What you manifest in your mind, you can bring to reality.
The Favorite. For a lot of people, it is their favorite movie of the year. It is that time, the award time of year, so there's a lot of movies that are vying for it. I could see this. I can understand why this would be nominated for a lot of things. However, I think that the praise this movie is getting is way overblown. It was a well-made movie. Let me start off with the good of this movie. Great acting. Okay. Great. And the writing's great. The set design and costume design for sure deserve every award, right? Some really sexy lesbian scenes, that's in the movie. Okay, plus. Cons, really hated the way it was filmed. The fisheye look just was super distracting and not consistent. There were some that were like literally just GoPro shots, and then there were other that are like there's some close-ups, and there's... It's just... I get he's they're trying to show off like the large... First off, it's made to make you feel small because it's about queens and royalty and wealthy people. So it's from a perspective of very low, you know, where you're looking up to these people. And you get to see the gorgeous set design. But it totally takes me out of the movie. So many of the fisheye scenes... my biggest problem with this movie is just the overall fact that it exists, because I have no desire to watch rich people have problems. I don't care. None of their problems mean anything to me. That like they, the fact that they're even alive, able to exist, and they treat humanity the way they treat humanity. You know, kings and queens and just I don't give a fuck about wealthy people problems. I do not care. And that's what this whole movie is, just the wah-wah wealthy people problems. Now, it's done in a good way. It's well written. The character is the acting's great. Don't get me wrong. I just, the subject matter of this movie, I just don't give a shit. And then the camera work just totally took me out. So there's some big problems with this. I can understand why some people like it, but it's so overdone. First off, the fact that like it's kind of weird because it has female characters, main characters. You got the queen, you got the lady, her like person filling in because the queen takes horrible care of herself. Like she just, I mean, they didn't know anything about nutrition or anything back then, but they were also royalty. So she had, you know, gout. She also probably had type 2 diabetes. Because she would just gorge on cakes and pastries and then throw up. Which is like, they show these scenes where it's like clearly she doesn't give a shit. She just like, she doesn't take any kind of care of herself. She just acts like a fucking glutton and just is disgusting, right? And but then there's this scene where I'm supposed to feel sympathy for her because she had 17 children die. You know, some during pregnancy, some, you know, while there were children. And this is a time where children died a lot. There was bad medicine back then. So children died a lot in general. And the reason why she there was 17 is because she's a fucking queen and she has to have the royal bloodline bullshit. So it's like, I have zero sympathy for that. I have zero. And on top of it, seeing how she treats her own body, I can only imagine how, while she was pregnant by a man, even though she's a lesbian, maybe she's bisexual, but clearly into women also, I would imagine she took excellent care of herself during those 9 months of pregnancy where she, I'm sure, didn't get, you know, plastered on whatever alcohol they had at the time. I'm sure she didn't gorge on sugar, just crushing her fucking pancreas, working over like fucking spikes in insulin and sugar levels. It's like, I have no sympathy for that. I have no sympathy for that. I used to have a supervisor who, super religious guy, and he had a giant family. He wanted to have a ton of kids. But his wife, every time she was pregnant, would have seizures and be put in ICU. She would almost die every time he had another one of his offspring because his DNA is so worthy of this world having fucking 20 kids. It's like, I can't have sympathy for a guy where every holiday season when he planned out his next pregnancy that his wife almost dies. Like, he doesn't seem to give a shit. She is under whatever control. She's willing because God or whatever. So it's like, this queen where I'm supposed to have sympathy, I've heard reviews of this movie where it's like, oh, it really made me feel sympathy for her because she lost 17 kids. Like, motherfucker, if she had a kid, it would be a miracle. If she had one survived the way she treats, and it's like, fuck, it's what? I don't give a shit. It's fucking monarchy. It's like, I don't, their story, their struggles are nothing compared to like all of the people that they squeeze the tax money out of. All of the people that live underneath them, you know, not much different than the world we live in here in America 2018, where corporations are the new kingdoms, CEOs are the new kings and queens. You know, they just, the government is a puppet for them and whatever they want to do with lobbying and just fundraising, whatever. This movie, I just don't, like, as far as stories go that I want to see, I don't want to see a whiny queen and, like, the politics. Oh, yeah, that's another thing I was going to say. So this, three main characters, women, great. Amazing, great job. I'm all for diversity. I'm all for women doing their movies and all that kind of stuff. I just need to point out to all the women that love this movie that aren't realizing that the one guy that's in this that has like a role is the kid from how was that movie about a boy, right? He's an adult now, but he's like, as a politician, as you know, there's war going on, they want to raise the taxes, he uses politics and his way to coerce people to get what he wants to make society better. Meanwhile, the main characters, these strong women, all they're doing is backstabbing and trying to get favor with the queen so they don't have to do shit, so they can get, you know, the servant. Emma Stone's character, she was a lady, you know, part a royal family, whatever. I don't know how it all worked. I don't know how the statures worked and the tiers of, you know, worthiness to be civilized back in those times. But it's like, she just wants to get married so she can be a lady again, and she's doing everything she can to just, it's like to compare it to, again, working at a job. It's like all of the people that get hired and promoted as managers, and all they do is kiss ass to do that. Like, they have no qualifications to be doing what they're doing, to be in charge of human beings or anything. All they do to get their status is by kissing the ass of the person above them, the person that does the hiring. And that's all this movie is about. The most petty bullshit, politics, just nothing. Like, they don't care about the people. It's all about, it's really not good about, it doesn't really say that many good things about females in this movie, is what I'm saying. It's not a very good movie. I mean, yes, she's the queen, and yes, there's women of power, but look how the situations are handled. See what their actual priorities are in this movie, and it's not, it's shameful. It's disgusting. I mean, it's because it's rich people problems. So it's not my favorite at all. There's many good things about this movie. And the director, Yorgos Lanthimos, you know, his last movie was Lobster. I enjoyed this more than Lobster, but overall, I'm not a big fan. New episodes of this show come out every day. Subscribe everywhere podcasts are found. Binge the show over at patreon.com/inspireddisorder. Inspireddisorder.com for all of my work, artwork, t-shirts like the one I'm wearing. Use coupon code THANKS18 to save 50%. On everything over at inspireddisorder.com. At Ray Taylor for me on all social media. Have a great day, everybody. Peace out!